Hi, hello students, welcome back. Today we are going to learn new lesson that is called Introduction to Photoshop CS3. This is class 7 and lesson 7. Topics are going to be covered in this lesson are how to start Photoshop, tools in Photoshop, creating a new file, inserting an image, saving a file, opening an existing file, selecting an image, moving an image, cropping an image, slicing an image, using brush and paint bucket, retouching, adding text to an image, layers in Photoshop 3, filters, Photoshop, file formats. Introduction. Have you ever thought how a picture in a poster or placard appears to be so perfect and flawless? It means exactly how it is placed, how the poster is created. That means all thanks to the development in technology that gave rise to Photoshop. So because of Photoshop, that poster or placard will be so perfect. Photoshop is a computer program that helps in beautification and manipulation of the pictures. The picture contains tools and applications that only helps in erasing the flaws. Flaws means drawbacks. But also helps in resizing, changing resolution, correcting image color, tone and others. Adobe Photoshop, commonly known as Photoshop, is an image or graphics editing program developed by Adobe Company. It is very popular among graphic artists, web designers, photographers and common people. That means everyone will use this easily. Everyone will use this software very easily. That is called Photoshop. First one is how to start Photoshop CS3. Click on start button. Click on all apps. Then step 3 from list of the Adobe Design Premium CS3. Select Adobe Photoshop CS3. Then Photoshop will open. Tools in Photoshop CS3. Photoshop is empowered with all kinds of possible tools that are required to meet the needs of a picture. Using the tools, one cannot only enhance the beauty of the picture, but can also change the look of the picture. That means a person can change the look of the picture. Photoshop tool palette is divided into 4 sections according to the nature of the work of the tools. First one is selection tools, next one is path, next one is text and shape tools, painting tools and view tools. You can look at here, the selection tools are here. By using this tool, selection tools, we will select the image. Next one is path, text and shape tools. By using this path, text and shape tool, we can enter the text in the Photoshop. We can may draw the shapes in the Photoshop. Next one is painting tools. By using these painting tools, we can paint the photos, or we can erase the photos, or we can erase the background of the image also. So we can draw the shapes by using this. That means we can color the shapes by using these painting tools. Next one is creating a new file. After opening the Photoshop, how to create the new file? Look at here, first step 1, click on new and in the file menu. Go to the file menu, click on the new option. A dialog box appears that gives the details such as name, size, resolution, background contents and color mode. And click OK. The blank sheet is open to create your own picture. So in this way we can create the new file. Next one is inserting the image. To insert an image, we need to follow the given step. Click on the place option from the file menu and place dialog box appears. Then select the image from the pictures or folders and click on place button. Next one is click on the image or drag it to point where you want to place it. Resize the image by dragging the convex mode and also rotate the image by placing the cursor slightly away from the corner node. Next one is press enter or double click the image when you have placed it on the desired location. Next one is saving a file. To save a file, click on save option from the file menu and save as dialog box appears. Type the name in the file name box and click on save button. The image will be saved. Next one is opening an existing file. To open an existing file, First, click on the open from the file menu. Open dialog box appears. Select the file that you want to open. Click open button. Then the file will be opened. Now let us look on a small video how to open an existing file, how to save a file, how to insert an image, how to create a new file, tools in photographs, how to start Photoshop CS3. You see here how to open first Photoshop. Click on start button. There is Adobe Photoshop CS6. I'm having this CS6. If you are having CS3, that's fine, or install the CS3, or right here in the search box Adobe here Photoshop CS6. I am opening this one. See, now it's open. If you observe here, this is the layout of the Photoshop. First one is title bar, next one is this is menu bar which contains menu, and this is called toolbox, and this is called toolbox, and this is toolbar, and see this particular tool options will come there, that is called toolbox, toolbar. Here you can see. Now first one is how to create a file. Click on file menu, click on new. A dialog box appears. If you want to write here name, you can write or click on OK. See, new file is created. Now again, how to insert a image or place the image. Click on file menu. As we discussed, there is a place option here. Click on place and select the image. Click on place. See, now there are the corners as we discussed. If you want to adjust, you can adjust. See, adjusted. Double click or press enter key. The image is placed and fixed. If you observe here, see the image is perfectly adjusted with the background. Now how to save this one? Click on file menu. There is a save option and place where you want to save. I am selecting desktop. New folder I will select and click on some apples. Click on save. Click on OK. Now click on file and click on close. See, it's closed. Now how to open an existing file? And click on file menu. There is a open option here, second option, and it's opening here, and select the file. Where is that one? See, apples Photoshop. Click on OK. See, we have opened the saved file. In this way we can open the existing files. And how to close? Here suppose you want to close, there is a file menu, click on close. Then this project will be closed, and if you click on this into mark, entire Photoshop application will be closed. See, again let us see how to open. Click on start button. There is Adobe Photoshop CS6. As for I am having CS3, but textbook it is CS3. I open this one. See, it's loading and it will open. In this way we can open, we can create new document in the Photoshop. First tool is marquee tool. Selecting an image, there are many selection tools in the Photoshop to select an image or area of an image or whole image. Let us discuss various selection tools. First one is marquee tools. The tool is used to make selections on the image. The tool includes rectangular, elliptical, single row and single column marquees. To select an area of an image or whole image through the marquee tool, follow the given step. First we need to open the image, right click the marquee tool and select the palette appears. Select any one of the four marquee tools from the marquee palette. Drag the mouse over the selected. The image gets selected by the moving the dotted line. Now let us have a look on a small video how to use the marquee tool. Yeah, see here, after opening the Photoshop, create the new. Then I'm going to the place an image. I'm going to insert apple image. And drag, if you want to drag the image, if you want to adjust the image, let it be adjusted. And if you want to move, go to the corner and you can turn the image also. So and press enter or double click the mouse. See, the image will be placed. Next, how to use the selection tools. First one is marquee tool. This first rectangle of the box, here it is there, and right click on this one and rectangular marquee tool. See here, it will select the image in rectangular part, rectangular square part. See, rectangle, now this is square. Next one is elliptical marquee tool. It will select the image in elliptical position, circular elliptical. See here, it is now selected in round color shape. Next one is single row. This one, see, singly. Next one is single column. See, this one is single row and single column. These are the tools of marquee tool. Next tool is lasso tool. Lasso tool is used to select the areas on the image. However, it gives the freedom to choose the irregular shapes, areas. Polylassical tool is used to select the object with lot of angles because of it draws only straight. Meanwhile, magnetic lasso tool is used to select the areas which have reasonably well defined edges. These tool consists of freehand, polygon and magnetic selection tools. Steps to given the below, let us have a look. Right click on the lasso tool, select the sub palette tools. Select any one of the three tools from the palette. Drag the mouse over the image to get the desired selection of an image. Let us have a small look on a video how to use lasso tool. Next one is lasso tools. Lasso tool is the freehand type tool. See here, right click, I selected lasso tool. Now what I will do, see, I will draw with my own. See, only exact path what you want you can select with the lasso tool. Next one is polylassy tool. That means first we will click on that one, second point where you want to keep, you can keep it. And if you, this is also with freehand tools. See, freehandly you can select this one. See, next one is in this lasso tool, there is a magnetic lasso. See here, if I keep one mouse pointer here, now when I move this one, it will take automatically edges. Edges will be taken automatically with the magnetic lasso tool. See here, I'm just moving here, it is automatically selecting the edges. What are the edges are there? It will select the edges. See, automatically it is selecting the edges. In this way we can use this magnetic lasso tool. Next tool is magic wand tool. Magic wand tool is used to select the adjacent area of an having same color. So how to use this magic wand tool is, let us see the step. Click on the magic wand tool, the shape of the mouse changes into magic wand, and click the portion of the image that selects a adjacent area of the pixel that has same color. The particular portion of image gets selected. Let us have a look on a small video how to use magic wand tool. Our next one is magic wand tool. Magic wand tool means it will, for example, I am opening the another image. I don't want this image. Now what I will do, I will click on new, place. I am going to place here laptop. Press enter key. See, magic wand tool, what it will do, if I click this part, particular part will be selected. See, only this part. See, By using this magnetic lasso tool, this will select the only automatically the part of an image, particular color of the image. By using this magic wand tool, it will automatically select the part of the image. That is called magic wand tool. Next one is quick selection tool. This tool is used to for quick selection of an image. When we drag the mouse, selection automatically finds the edges of the images and expands towards them. Let us see the steps. Click on right click on the magic wand tool and select the quick selection tool from the list appear. Drag the mouse over the image to select it. Let us have a look on a video how to quick selection the image. There is a quick selection also there. Right click here and quick selection. What it will do, see here. Click and drag it, hold and drag it. It will select automatically how much part you want. See here, but the completely laptop, it was selected, see. Only that part, that much area it will select. That is called quick selection tool. Next one is how to move an image. We can also move the image from one place to another with the help of the move tool. Open the image and select the part of an image that you want to move the using with any one of the selection tool. When desired portion is of an image gets selected, click the move tool and place the mouse on the selected part and drag it into desired location. Then your selected part of the image will move to one place to other place. Next one is cropping an image. Cropping tool is used to move the unwanted portion of the image and it works. In other words, to retain the desired area of an image. The area outside of the selection is removed from the screen. To crop the image, we need to follow the below steps. Click on the image, click on the crop tool, drag the mouse over the part of an image that you want to retain. Rest the portion will be removed. Press enter key, image gets cropped. Using brush and paint bucket tool. First one is pencil tool. Pencil tool is used to draw the freehand drawing with the hard edges. Next one is brush tool. Brush tool is used to paint with smooth edges. I will show the steps how to draw the freehand drawing and how to fill the smooth edges with the brush tool. Color replacement tool. Color replacement tool is used to replace any color of an image without losing any detail. Open the image. Click on the color replacement tool, select the color from the color palette, paint over the area whose color want to change. Next topic is paint bucket tool. Paint bucket tool is used to fill or paint an entire selection of part of an image. How to select the steps? Let us see. Click on the paint bucket tool, choose the color from the color palette, click on the part of an image. The colored portion gets changed. You can change the background color by clicking its empty area around the image. Now I'm going to show one video how to use the paint bucket tool, how to use color replacement tool, how to use brush and paint bucket and pencil tools, and how to crop an image, how to move an image. Yeah, after opening this one, first we'll open the one image. You know how to open the image. I am opening the recent one, that is April PSD image. Now let us see what is how to move an image. See, I am selecting this elliptical marquee tool to select the part in circles or elliptical space. Now I selected this part, select move tool and move the part. See, next one, not only this one, by using now I am using this lasso tool. See, I am drawing this part. See, by using move tool, you can move this part. In this way, you can move any part of the image by using the selection tools. Now, next topic is cropping an image. How to crop an image? Cropping means, see, there is a cropping image here. You observe here, there is a cropping tool. Now remove the unwanted area. See, I need only this much part only. So I will crop the image. Don't want those all the things. See, press enter key. See, only that much part the image will be processed. Only that much part will be selected. That is called cropping the image. Here cropping will be there. Shortcut key is C. See, this is the cropping. See, this is the cropping tool. Next one is using brush and paint bucket color replacement tool. Now I'm closing this one. I don't want to don't crop. No, Control plus N to create new, and new document has been created. And first one is brush tool. See here, pencil tool use it to draw the lines or draw the freehand shapes like this. See here, I'm drawing the lines. So then what is the brush? Brush is like some kind of thick colors. Now after drawing that one, I want to color this area. See, brushing. This is called brush. You can reduce the size also by right click and reduce. See, only this much also it's coming. So in this way we can reduce the size also, size of the brushes. So next one is color replacement tool. Our next topic is color replacement tool. Color replacement means, see here, in this only brushing tool. Now right click and there is color replacement. So which color you want to? This color, no? See, red color. I am changing it into, let it be in the green. See, wherever the color is there, it will fill those parts. See, the yellow color also there, so it will not go outside now. See, only wherever the color is there, it will fill in those parts only. Same here, increase the size also. So in this way, you can, this is called color replacement tool. Only particular area, suppose there exactly I cannot draw the same color. So instead of that one, so if you want to, in this way we can replace the colors in the, by using the color replacement tool. And next one is paint bucket tool. Everybody knows what is this paint bucket tool. This is, one second, see here, in this gradient below the eraser, right click, there is a paint bucket tool. Fill the color, which color you want. Selected this one and this area, see. Now next one, if you want different color. Now next one, if you want here some extra color, see, in this way, by using paint bucket tool, we can fill those areas. This is called paint bucket tool. Next one is gradient tool. Gradient tool means we can use this gradient tool whenever we want blend of two or more colors in our image. There are five types of gradient: linear, radial, angle, reflected and diamond gradient. So how to apply this gradient? See here, open an image, select the part of an image where you want to fill the gradient fill. Next one, choose any one of the selections. We have taken the quick selection tool. Right click the paint bucket tool and select gradient from the palette. Click the gradient sample in the context menu. Gradient editor will be appeared. Select any one of the gradients and click on OK. So by using this gradient tool, we can fill the two or more colors in our image or in our document. Next one is burn and dodge tool. Burn tool is used to darken the areas of the image, and while dodge tool used to lighten the parts of an image. Eraser tool is used to erase the color of an image. Spot healing brush is used to create the unwanted scratches and blemishes, dark spots of an image by covering the area with the sample that Photoshop automatically selects from the surrounding area. By using this spot healing brush tool, we can remove the unwanted spots or pimples like that. So next one is healing brush tool. This tool also fix the scratches, blemishes and dark spots of an image like spot healing brush tool.
बट स्लाइटली डिफरेंट वे. यू नीड टू सेलेक्ट द सोर्स पॉइंट विद द हेल्प ऑफ द ऑल्ट की बिफोर द अप्लाई. दैट मीन्स लाइक इट्स लाइक सेम लाइक स्पॉट हीलिंग ब्रश, बट हियर वी नीड टू सेलेक्ट द सोर्स विद द ऑल्ट की. सो दैट इज द स्मॉल डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन द स्पॉट हीलिंग एंड हीलिंग ब्रश टूल. नेक्स्ट वन इज पैच टूल. पैच टूल इज यूज टू सेलेक्ट द इरेगुलर शेप्ड पोर्शन ऑफ एन इमेज. सपोज ए इमेज इज नॉट परफेक्टली फाइन, बाई यूजिंग पैच टूल वी कैन कंसील इट, वी कैन फिक्स इट विद द पैच टूल. नेक्स्ट वन इज क्लोन स्टैम्प टूल. इट विल क्लोन स्टैम्प टूल इज यूज टू डुप्लीकेट द इमेज और पार्ट ऑफ एन इमेज बाई सेलेक्टिंग द सैम्पल पॉइंट इन द इमेज टू बी क्लोनड. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू शो वन स्मॉल वीडियो हाउ टू यूज क्लोन स्टैम्प, पैच टूल, हीलिंग ब्रश टूल, स्पॉट हीलिंग ब्रश, बॉर्न एंड डॉज एफेक्ट, ग्रेडियंट टूल. लेट अस हैव ए लुक. यस, सी हियर, फर्स्ट ग्रेडियंट आई एम क्रिएटिंग न्यू वन एंड क्लिक ऑन ओके. And there is right click here, paint bucket tool or gradient. I am selecting gradient, then click on the gradient editor and select the color which one you want to apply. Now I am selecting here this one and click on OK. First one is here linear gradient. See, draw the line. See, background will be like this. Next one is radial gradient. See, if I select that one, one same kind of circles will come. See, background. So next one is angle gradient. See, particular angle, whatever the angle you draw, for example 90 degrees, this is like this, see here 180 degrees, like this. In this way we can, angle gradient will be there. Next one is, this one is reflected gradient. It's similar to linear. See, it will get reflected. See, next one is, final one is diamond. Diamonds will be appear here. See, diamond gradient. So this is called gradient tool. So next one is, I am going to open Apple's image. See, what is bone tool and dodge tool. Here under down, right click here, this is a dodge tool. See what dodge tool will do. Here make it right click and increase the size. See, as we discussed it, now it will, dodge tool will increase the light in the area of the image. So it will increase the light. And what about burn tool? See, it will increase that part. If I use burn tool, see, it will darken that area. It will darken that area. So that is the difference between the burn tool and dodge tool. See, dodge tool will, next one is there also, there sponge tool also there. See, it's not coming exactly. See, it's sponge tool will, similarly it will make the image like sponge, smoothness, for smoothness of the image. See, you can observe the difference here. See, very little. See, have you observed here? Smoothen the parts. It is called shining kind of thing. So by using the sponge tool, it will come the shining. See, this is called sponge tool. Next one is burner. Next one is spot healing tool. I'm going to show, close this image, I'm not saving, and I'm opening one more spot healing. For example, see, spot healing brush tool. If you observe here, there is a pimple. See, when I click that one, automatically spots will be removed, just like this. So spot healing brushes, in this way we can remove the spots of an image. You can see here, when I open the right click and click on spot healing, please select the spots. In this way we can remove the spots. And last one is, sorry, next one is healing brush. Healing also, similarly right click and there is healing. first where we which screen we need to right alt click and select this part and click here. See, suppose you want keep this part here. See in this way, that is called spot healing brush tool and healing brush tool. In this way we can remove the pimples and everything. Next one is patch tool. Patch tool is under here only. See, right click and there is a spot healing, and third one is patch tool. For example, this area, this pipe is there, right? It's looking like unwanted area. So what I will do, first select the part where you want to remove. I don't want this area. And see, now if you move that one up to here, this part like this, press enter and see here magic, that area has been patched. So you can select like this also, just draw one big arrow and move this patch. This area should be there. See, this has been patched. So in this way, that is called patch. Next one, patch healing. Next one is clone stamp. Clone stamp is equal to, see here, right click and clone stamp, which part of area you want. Press alt click and one left click and move the mouse pointer here in the other place and just click and hold. See, same kind of stamp here and same image. Now I'm clicking one more photograph. You can select the size also if you want, and I click this one and I want to place one more bird here. See, in this way, right click and alt plus. So this is called clone stamp. Wherever you want to keep the birds, you can keep same this kind of bird you want here. So this is called clone stamp. So in this way, the stamp, clone stamp tool will works. Next one is adding text to an image. Adding text to an image, often pictures are incompletely without any descriptions. So this description could be anything, ranging from the definition of a picture, feelings of significance of image, or simple wishes. There can be Adobe Photoshop provides this facility to type the text inside the image. Type tool is present in the toolbar. Displayed in the left side, it denoted T. Clicking on the tool switches the typing mode. When you type mode, it is enabled. Option bar appear with the top window, providing some options and design the style and appearance of the text. So by using text tool, we can write the text of an image. Next one is type tool and wrapping text. Type tool, click on the type tool and click inside the canvas. Type the text. After entering the text, you can change the font style, size and color of the text. Wrapping text, it is used to give the defined shape of the text. Suppose particular size of the text. So click on the type tool, click inside the canvas and type the text. Select the text and click on the create wrap text on the option bar. The wrap text dialog box appears. Select the style of your choice and click on OK. Next topic is layers in Photoshop. Photoshop layers can be thought as a separate films. So much like transparency sheets, each layer contains its own discrete contents. Individual layers contain objects which together create your composite image, that means final image. You can change one layer without affecting the other layers of the background of the image, so make the work easier. So to create a layer, new layer is created automatically when you paste an object to the image. You can also create new layer at your choice. To create a new layer, click on the layer menu and click the new layer and select layer option from the list. New layer box appears. Type the layer name and layer name box and click on OK. New layer is created on the layer palette. So layers means it is simple kind of transparent sheets. Each layer contains its own discrete contents. Next one is renaming or deleting the layers. To rename a layer, double click on the layer name in the layer palette and type the new name. Then automatically layer name will be changed. Next, to delete the layer, go to the layer palette to select the layer that you want to delete. Click on layer menu and select delete, then layer option, click on yes when confirmation dialog box appears, then layer will be automatically deleted. Next one is hiding and showing merging layers. So to hide the layer, click on the eye icon present in the leftmost column in the color palette. Click on the eye icon, again show it. So we can hide it and we can unhide the layers also. To merge the layers, click on the layer menu and select merge layers option. Merging means making 2 to 3 layers into one, that is called merging. Next topic is filters. Filters can help to give a special effect of an image or selected portion of an image. There is a long list in inbuilt filters of the Photoshop. To open image, click on filter menu, desired category of filter, click the desired filter to apply. That means it will give some special effect to the object. Photoshop file formats, this is our last topic. So Photoshop file format, it is very easy, essential to choose the correct file format while saving the image. So first one is PSD. PSD means it is the Photoshop format. So when you open this kind of file, when you save this kind of files, then it will open in only in Photoshop. So it cannot be viewed in normal photo. So these PSD formats will be opened in only in Photoshop. Next one is JPEG, Joint Photographic Export Group. The file format commonly used in extension to the image files. That means the image widely used by the people. It is easily uploaded, transferred, shared. That means this JPEG image can be easily transformed from the one place to other places also. That means normal images. GIF means graphics interchange format. The file format commonly used extension for the web graphics, for web files and web photos. Then they will use this kind of formatted images. Next one is PNG. PNG is portable network graphics. It is considered as a better format than GIF, ability to support all level of transparency. That means for transparency images we are using PNG format images. So now I'm going to show one video, what are filters and hiding and showing, merging layer, renaming it and delete layers, layers in Photoshop, type tool and wrapping text, and adding text to the image. Let us have a look. Yeah, see here, now I open the Photoshop. Now I created one new document and I'm going to place one object here. See, I placed one apple object over here. Yeah. Now what I will do, I will use text tool. This one is called text or type tool. See, now click here anywhere and I'm going to write the text here. Apples are good for healthy, like quotations. See, I written apples are good for health. See, so when I click here apples layer, see, I hided that one. See this, if you observe this eye symbol, if I have that one, this is one layer forward. See, first background we created and later we imported that image. See, image is placed and later we created one more layer. See, that is called apples are good for health. Now I want to write one more thing, good morning, like that. So again text tool and type anywhere. See, again new layer one is formed. Now I'm writing here have a nice day. Where is this one? Yeah, see, good morning, have a nice day. I want to change the color, then select the text and here color is there. See, I'm going to keep already background is red. So that will be some kind of sky blue color. So now see, in this way we can, now I made some kind of poster type. So what is here, wrap text. Suppose I want to bend these letters, I want to make curve thing. So but I cannot make the curves. So how can I do? By using the wrap text. Select the text and click on this, select the text here, and there is here wrap text here. Select that one, dialog box appears and like arch. See, See, now text has formed in the arc way. That is called wrap text. See, now how many layers formed? Apple is one layer. See, first I created background, then apple layer formed, then trees are good, and next one is good morning, have a nice day. In this way, the text tool and type tool will be used. Next one is, these are the layers, layer palettes are this side, and here next one is, just now I'm going to show you how to rename the layers. See, suppose apple is there, double click, and I'm writing here apple image, enter. See, rename it, just double click and rename. Suppose I want to, when it is in different layer, we can move, or we can move particular text. Suppose if I merge this one to down one, right click and this one, delete layer. Here if you see this, this is called delete layer. See, if I click this one, delete layer, then it will be deleted. Now I want to merge down, so because this image is different, so what I will do, see, it's moving here and there. So what I will do, I'll make it right click and merge down, so it will becomes only one image. See, I can't move now. In this way we can merge the images. Now one more thing is, final topic is filter. Click on the filter, and what are the type you want to give the, see, for example here, now blur or resort, I'm blurring the image, motion blur. See, image becomes some blurry kind of thing. So in this way we can apply the filters.
Okay students, that's all for today's class. Meet you next class. Till then, take care and stay safe.